Trudeau's justice minister said, if you are a member of pro-Trump movement, then your bank account can be frozen. If this does not send shivers up your spine, then you, my friend, have no spine at all.
A lot of folks says, look, I just don't like your vaccine mandates and I donated to this. Now it's illegal. Should I be worried that the bank can freeze my account? What's your answer to that?
Well, I think if you are a member of a pro-Trump movement who's donating hundreds of thousands of dollars or millions of dollars to this kind of thing, then you ought to be.
Prime Minister Justin Trudeau has declared a state of emergency, which is effectively a martial law, which means people don't have civil rights. And what's the reason for that? Why did he do that? Because people want freedom. People don't want mask mandates. They don't want vaccination mandates. They're sick and tired of it everywhere. And people wanting their freedom is not a radical idea. It's not a radical idea at all. Government doesn't grant us freedom. It's a God-given right. And look at the hypocrisy. When farmers' protests were going on in India, at that time, the same pretty boy, Justin Trudeau, said, oh my God, we support all the protests. Oh my God, we should do this, we should do that. But the moment a protest happens in Canada, what does he do? He declares emergency.
Canada will always be there to defend the right of peaceful protest. We believe in the importance of dialogue, and that's why we've reached out through multiple means directly to the Indian authorities.
Individuals are trying to blockade our economy, our democracy, and our fellow citizens' daily lives. It has to stop.
And can you believe at the time when Indian protests were happening, Indian government was talking to the protesters, trying to figure out what they can do to solve the problem. Justin Trudeau has not talked to these protesters at all. In fact, it's really strange. A video just surfaced now in which he was asked many years ago, which country does he look up to? And his answer was China. And you know the reason for that? Because he likes the dictatorship there.
He was asked which country he most admired and referred to China.
There's a level of admiration I actually have for China. Because their basic dictatorship is allowing them to actually turn their economy around on a dime and say, we need to go green as fast as we need to start, investing in solar. I mean, there is a flexibility that I know Stephen Harper must dream about of having a dictatorship that he could do everything he wanted. That I find quite interesting.
And by the way, last week, you remember how I talked about how GoFundMe had blocked the donations to the Freedom Convoy and had said that we are three steps away from banks freezing your accounts if they don't like your politics? Remember that? I was wrong. We were not three steps away. They are doing it right now. They are freezing the accounts of people whose politics they don't like. Trudeau's justice minister said, if you are a member of pro-Trump movement, then your bank account can be frozen. If this does not send shivers up your spine, then you, my friend, have no spine at all. I mean, can you imagine if Trump did the same thing back in 2020 during the BLM riots? In the sense that he declared a martial law and then he froze the accounts of all the rioters and anybody who donated to BLM? Can you imagine that? We called Trump a dictator, Hitler, for doing nothing. And now when this actual thing is happening in Canada, there's not a peep from the media against them. So think for yourself, wake up, but don't be woke.
You are listening to Radio Zindagi, GA Jaa.